This is Quick Q. Got a science or tech question? Your guides have the answers. I'm Sydney Hamilton, I'm an aerospace engineer, and today I'm your guide.
Why do you love satellites so much?
Because it keeps us connected. And I think now more than ever, we see how important it is to be able to stay connected with each other. You get to play games with your friends, you get to see them on video chat, even us having this talk right now, satellites are playing a major part of it.
What does an aerospace engineer do?
So as an aerospace engineer, I've had the opportunity to work on airplanes and in the space sector. For me personally, I work on reflectors. That's a part of a satellite. They can be up to 100 inches wide, but they're made out of composite material, which is like a fabric and a glue put together, so they're super light.
Do satellites crash in space and that's why my Wi-Fi doesn't work?
There's actually a super small chance that a satellite would even crash in space. There are teams and teams of people watching every single satellite to make sure that doesn't happen. So if your Wi-Fi's not working, it's probably just your Wi-Fi provider.
Are satellites far away?
Satellites are really far away. They're about 22,000 miles away. That's 367,000 soccer fields. You can launch a satellite into space today. Satellites are attached to rockets, and rockets drop the satellites off in space. So we're gonna make sure we attach our satellite to the rocket, and from here, we're ready for takeoff. What you wanna do is measure out a long piece of string and have two support systems that you can tie it to. First, you're gonna tie it to your first support system, which can be a doorknob or a chair. And then you wanna grab your straw, put the string through the straw, and then tie the other end of the string to your other chair or doorknob. Once you have those together, you're gonna make sure that your balloon is attached to your straw. Once we do this, we remove the clip or just let go of the balloon and it'll take off. And there you have it, your balloon rocket.
What has been your favorite engineering project and what challenges did you face?
So my favorite project has been 3D printing parts for satellites. Finding out that we can print in aluminum and titanium and that it can still go to space. It definitely came with challenges though. I had never designed for 3D printing and it's totally different than the design work I had done before. That learning curve was really steep, but I had some really great teammates who sat with me and taught me so many things, so it was really cool to be able to learn how to do additive manufacturing or 3D printing.
When did you become interested in space and how did you decide engineering was the path for you?
Ever since I was a little girl, I've always been fascinated with the sky. I would look up and just wonder what else is out there. And so it makes sense that I'm an aerospace engineer now. I decided engineering was the path for me because I've always loved numbers.
How many satellites are in the sky and what happens if they stop working?
So there are actually a few thousand satellites in the sky. Only about 1,700 of them are active. When it's starting to die, we use the last bit of fuel before it runs out and we send it back into Earth. The ones that are left in space, just still in orbit. There are companies right now developing new ways to figure out how can we bring all of that space junk back. Space junk is just the dead satellites that are still going around the globe. So how do we clean that up? It's an emerging career path in the aerospace industry that's really fascinating.
Have you added more female engineers to the Wing Woman, which I love the name. And if so, how many are a part of your group now?
So the Wing Women started off as a group of two. That's me and one of my best friends. We work together to help each other find our voice in the workplace. It just continues to grow as more of a movement to say, hey, I'm here to help you. I'm here to make sure that we as a group of women in engineering help support each other. Do exactly what you love to do and know that there will be challenges along the way, but find your support group that'll keep pushing you to do the things that you love. Work hard so that you can make your dreams a reality. Be sure to visit GoldieBlox.com to explore the rest of Basecamp and work on earning your badges. Click the link in the description below to get the behind the scenes of tracking and monitoring snakes and other creatures with my friend Sam. And a huge thank you to Lyda Hill Philanthropies for making this episode possible.